Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM AppConnect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate a new capability in version 12 called Business Transaction Monitoring. I will describe the key concepts and demonstrate an overview of how to configure and use Business Transaction Monitoring. This new capability allows you to monitor a transaction end-to-end through various message flows deployed on different integration servers that are owned by an integration node, so you can track and view the lifecycle of a message as it is processed by AppConnect Enterprise. So, a business transaction is a unit of function from a business perspective. This slide shows some examples of business transactions. A customer ordering process has different transactions, which validates the order, checks if a customer is a gold or regular customer, and then completes the transaction. A holiday booking comprises of booking the flight and hotel and making a payment and confirming the booking. An administrator may need to monitor business transactions and use queries to check the status of certain transactions. So this slide illustrates the concepts of how business transaction monitoring works. Business transaction monitoring, or BTM for short, requires you to define monitoring events in your message flows. Each monitoring event must have a global transaction identifier. This is needed so that AppConnect Enterprise can correlate the monitoring events as part of a single business transaction. Having defined your and deployed your message flows with monitoring events, you can create a business transaction definition. A business transaction definition comprises of individual business events. In the business event, you specify which monitoring event is part of a business transaction by defining it with a particular type. The types that you can have are start, progress, end, and failure. These business events are used to correlate the state of a business transaction. A business transaction definition must have a start and end business event as a minimum. So in this example, we have a business transaction definition which has been created with six business events. The overall state of a business transaction is correlated using the customer order number that is contained in the message. The order placed business event is defined as a start event. The confirmed, dispatched, and delivery attempted business events are in progress types of business events. Delivery successful is an end event, and shipment missing is a failure event. An instance of a business transaction is recorded, and each instance can be in a different state: in progress, complete, failed, or inconsistent. In this case, an instance of a business transaction is an individual customer order. So here we can see there are four transactions. The first transaction has completed successfully. It is in the complete state. The second transaction has failed. It's in the failed state because the shipment went missing. The third transaction is in progress as a start event was received. And the fourth transaction is also in progress. The order, you can see the order was placed, it was dispatched, and the delivery has been attempted. But delivery has not been successful yet, so it is in progress. This slide gives an overview of what configuration is needed. In order to use business transaction monitoring, you must have a database and IBM MQ installed. Currently, only DB2 and Oracle databases are supported by IBM AppConnect Enterprise for business transaction monitoring. Configuration must be made in the node.conf.yaml to enable monitoring for node-owned servers that have the message flows deployed. A data store must be defined in the serverconf YAML for the integration server that is used for recording the data to the database. So let's have a look at doing a live demo here. So here on my system, I have a main flow here, which takes messages and sends them off to different flows. So if I click on the canvas here, we can see there are three events, monitoring events configured in this particular flow. There's an event on this node here in the out terminal. There's another event on the send retail response node here. and there's an event on unknown order. If I click on this message flow node and select the event, you can see that it has a global correlation identifier defined, and it is using the customer number that is in the message. Okay, so this is required so that you can link the different monitoring events for a business transaction. I have other flows here so that they handle the request that comes in, an order is sent to dispatch, and then a response is sent to confirm that the order has been sent. I have three servers here. I have on server one, an application which contains this message flow for handling the overall message requests that come in. I have server two, which has these three message flows deployed to it. And I have a third server called Server for Recording, whose only job is to record data to the database, so it has no flows deployed to it. In order to configure this, I have set up entries, a configuration in my node.conf.yaml in the overrides directory. So if I open this up, you can see I've specified a default queue manager to use. I've specified that monitoring is enabled, so set to active, and the monitoring event is monitoring event V2, and I've also defined the business event as well. I have three servers defined, and I have a specialist server called Server for Recording, and in there I have set up configuration for it to define a data store. And my data store is called BTM data store, and it's using a database called MB record. I have already defined my database tables in my database. So I ran the script provided by AppConnect Enterprise to create the tables. And so those tables are already created. And I have a queue manager, which is used by the integration node, and I have the relevant system queues defined. So now that I have my configuration set up in my YAML files and I have my flows deployed, I can proceed with creating a business transaction definition. So I will open the web UI for the node. So this is the web UI for the node. It has three servers there. And so server one has a retail app, which has the flow for handling the messages. And server two has another application with three flows deployed to it. So new in version 12 is this new icon here, which says business transactions. If I select that, the business transactions page is shown. It has two tabs, monitor and configure. So I haven't yet created a business transaction definition. I'm going to create one now. So if I click on the configure tab, I have an option here to create a business transaction definition. So I go ahead and click that. I'm going to select the integration server, which will be used for recording. So I'm going to use my server for recording, and I'll give a name for my business transaction definition. I'll call it order item. I need to specify the details, and they're stored in the policy project. So I'm going to create policy project here, and I'm going to call it order item policy project. And I'm going to create a policy in there, and I'm going to call it order item policy. So if I click create there, it has now created the initial business transaction definition. There are no business events defined in it yet. I'm going to create some business events for it so that it defines what constitutes the business transaction. So first of all, I'm going to specify a start event. So I'm going to give it a name, and I'm going to call it start event. And this is of type start. And this will be the monitoring event will be emitted by Flow on the on integration server, server one. And I select the application. It's not from a library. I specify the message flow, which is main process order flow. And in here, it will show me the events, monitoring events that are configured. And I'm going to select this top one, retail request. Receive retail request. And if I click create, it has now created the start event. So I'm going to create the progress events now. So first one I'm going to create is business event, which receives the order. And this will be a progress event. This will be a flow that's deployed to integration server two. And I specify my application and set my flow. So this is coming from the request flow. And I can select which monitoring event to use. And this is coming from the order item input queue node. So I can click create there. I can now see the progress event has been added. I'll just create the other progress events as well. So this is going to be a progress event for dispatch. And it is another progress event. Specify the server, the application, the message flow, dispatch, and this is in the compute terminal in. So now I'll create my third progress event, and this is going to confirm that the item was ordered. So it is a progress event. I'll select the server, the application, the message flow is the response flow, and the monitoring event is the confirm item orders node. So I can create that. And so I have a start and three progress events. So it's not ready yet. I need to define a end event. So this will be called send response. It's an end event. This is going to be on an application running on server one. And the flow is the main process flow. And the monitoring event is the send retail response. And finally, I'm going to add a failure event too. So this is when a request comes in for an unknown order, unknown item. So I will select a failure event here and select server one, which is where the flow is deployed. And select the main process order and select the monitoring event, which is unknown order. So there I have created my business events. So I have six business events there in my business transaction definition. So now I've created them, I can start monitoring. Okay, so monitoring is now started. And so now I can click on the monitoring tab. No messages have been sent in yet, so nothing is showing here yet. So let's go ahead and send some messages in. Okay, so I've sent some messages in, and now if I refresh, I can see some messages are showing now. I can see some are in progress, but some that have failed and some have completed. So I can select any of these business transactions, and I can see that this one has completed and it has received all of the business events, and I can select any of these events and see the details off that business event. So I can also filter by type. So I can select which transactions are complete or in progress or consistent or failed. So for example, if I want to see the only ones that are in progress, then I can see if they're currently 16 in progress. If I want to just see the ones that have failed, then I can see 10 transactions have failed. So if I want to see why they have failed, so I have configured the monitoring event to include the payload. So when it comes to this monitoring event, to where it says it's an unknown order, I can click on that and I can actually see the data of a message for that monitoring event. So I can see here that an invalid request was received, and I can also see errors here as well. So this allows you to see all the transactions that were received, and you can see the individual business events. In summary, I have shown you an overview of the concepts of business transaction monitoring. I defined the monitoring events on the message flows and used a global correlation ID in each monitoring event so they can be linked to a single instance of a business transaction. I defined a business transaction definition on the configure tab of the business transactions page. And in there, I defined 6 different business events for that business transaction definition. Each business event referenced a monitoring event, which was defined in the message flow. So after sending in the messages, I could monitor the business transactions using the monitor tab. And this showed me instances of a business transactions and the overall state, which was either in progress, complete, inconsistent, or failed. And I could click on any individual business transaction to see details of the business event.